Hello, my name is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Today we're going to be looking at the brand new plugin mTutorial, which is now available for Final Cut Pro. Now, if you're someone like me who makes tutorials online, this is a really phenomenal pack of tools, and I can't wait to share just a few of these tools with you now. So let's jump into Final Cut Pro. All right, so here we are in Final Cut Pro. I've got a couple screenshots of Final Cut Pro, Apple Motion, the MotionVFX website, and our introduction, just so we can give you some idea of the various tools that are available in mTutorial. mTutorial comes with 7 add-ons, 8 backgrounds, 14 focus options, 9 guides, 8 lower thirds, 13 miscellaneous tools, 13 placeholders, 11 pointers, 17 titles, and 7 transitions. So if I were to be discussing a tutorial in Final Cut Pro and I wanted to show that I want to discuss the titles section in Final Cut Pro, I could use several of my different highlight or focus options, as you can see here. So for instance, if I wanted to discuss highlight number 1, I could simply drag my title, highlight number 1, and as we push down, we can see that that is animated. Use our on-screen controls to drag over top of our highlight 1 section, and very easily use our on-screen controls to bring that down and center it up where we'd like it to be. Now, something else that we have over here in our inspector is we can also use, of course, the inspector's parameters if we want to really get in there and fine tune, but we can also make adjustments to our curvature, meaning if we'd like to square that off, we just turn our curvature down, and now we continue to use those on-screen controls, and we've got a nice box there to highlight our area. mTutorial also comes with different transitions that are located in mTutorial in your transition section. Again, we have 7 transitions. They're all unique, but all have a similar stylistic theme, so you can use multiple transitions in a project and they're all going to flow very well together. I'm really enjoying transitions 3 and 4. Of course, just like any transition, click, drag in between 2 clips. And you can see that we are picking up our first clip and then moving on into our second clip. And of course, you can highlight your transition, make changes to your text, font, subtitle text, etc., as well as background color. So now we're looking at a screenshot of Apple Motion. Let's say in this particular case, we want to indicate that we are going to right click on a certain area. We have our add-ons section here with mouse 1 and 2. Both are very usable. Why don't we just pick up mouse 1 as a title? And you can see our mouse comes up and we've got our on-screen controls. And we can go ahead and check out our action and animation actions. We're indicating that we want to make a right click on a particular section of this tutorial. So why don't we just turn off our left click in our action section and we can click right click. Now, what if we want it to be animated? That's okay. Click animated actions. Let's go ahead and toggle that on. And now our action is animated as well to draw the user's attention to what we are going to be doing. Why don't we scroll down in our title section of mTutorial to our pointers? You can see a lot of different options here. One that's a lot of fun is our magnifying glass. We can just drag this on again as a title. It is pre-animated, and the fun thing about this is it is giving us a bit of a magnification, and we can make changes to that magnification's axis. So if we want to make sure that we are offsetting that, and we are magnifying on top of our HUD here. We make those quick changes in our magnification offsets, and now we know that we are going to be right over top of that area. Again, using on-screen controls to make sure that we are right there where we want to be. So let's check out that pre-animated title. Let's scroll back up, and we've got all of these different background options that are a lot of fun that just give a little bit of movement while you may be discussing something on the screen. Why don't we use background number 6? And we're going to drag it beneath our screenshot. Let's make sure that that is the same duration. I'll turn snapping on. I can do it here or by tapping N. There we go. And we are now snapping. And you can see that the transition is taking that background into account as well with that movement. So you stay on theme and on brand. I'm going to scale that up a bit more, maybe around there. There we go. Click done. And now you've got that fun pre-animated background happening while we're taking a look at the screen that you may be doing your tutorial with. Now, let's say that you don't know who I am, or maybe you just need some sort of a lower third. Don't worry, we've got you covered with 8 different lower thirds. And of course, you don't have to use these lower thirds just for names, but there are several that are pre-built to indicate the name and maybe the credit of the person on the screen. So why don't we just use lower third number 6? We'll bring that in, and we can see we will change this really quickly in our inspector to George Edmondson. And I am MVFX tutor. We can use our on-screen controls to place these wherever we would like. I think that looks good right there, but I'm not exactly sure if that is accurate because I don't have any guides on my screen. Not to worry, we've got you covered with our guides tool. So the first guide that I want to make sure is to use safe zones. So we can see MVFX tutor was a little bit below my safe zone here. So we're going to click that and just bring that up slightly. And now we know my text is in my safe zone. Okay, let's delete that. Now I want to make sure that the composition of my shot is accurate. So why don't we use composition tools, drag that on top. And we are going to use the golden ratio. I'm going to go in my inspector. We're going to flip the golden ratio, and let's flip it vertically. So now we can see around where that golden ratio is happening. So we know if we want that to be accurate, I need to actually be framed a bit to the right. So we're going to highlight my clip, use our transform tools, scale up just a bit, and push that over. And now we know that I'm closer to that golden ratio. Let's scale a bit more. There we go. And we really quickly just used that guide. We know that my George Edmondson MVFX tutor lower third is in our broadcast safe area. We know that I am framed with that beautiful golden ratio. So let's just click done, and we can delete those composition tools if we'd like. And now we know we are looking golden. Now, what if we wanted to draw attention to something else? We've got our focus tools again. This one is so much fun, and I just wanted to show it off before I let you all go. Highlight number 4, let's drag that on. And check this out, that is following our path on all of these different on-screen controls. How fun is that? So if you wanted to add some little squigglies or something like that, you can do it. So I'm going to use this to very quickly squiggle out or maybe highlight, draw attention to the Emmy that we just won for a documentary that we created. So there you go. There's the highlight following that path. Tons of fun. And of course, you've got your color, your opacities, etc. right over here. The final thing I'd like to show you all before we go is going to be our placeholders options. And these are great as standalone tools, or you can use them over top of existing footage, but you can absolutely use them as standalone as well. So you can, of course, drop these as titles over top of maybe a talking head or something like that, or you can use these in your primary timeline as standalone options. Something else that you can always do, you can mix and match things obviously very easily. So we could use one of our backgrounds beneath this, and now we've got a beautiful animated background. Colors are all going to match very easily, or you can, of course, make changes to your color parameters. You have your drop zones. There is just so much in these tools that we can't even cover everything. So I highly encourage you to go and check mTutorial out, now available from MotionVFX.com. Again, my name is George Edmondson. Be sure to subscribe, and we will see you on the next one.